Welcome to Digital Communication Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be discussing advantages and disadvantages of digital communication system. So in this session, we will see why do we use digital communication system, how many advantages that is there with digital communication system, and what are the drawbacks which is there with digital communication system. So let us begin this session with advantages. So first advantage, that is storing capability. Now see, we all know digital signal could be easily stored, right? And nowadays, even if you see the devices, digital devices which is available, like smartphone that we have, so in that nowadays memory of storing that is available in terms of gigabytes, right? One can store 50 movies in their smartphone. In computers, memory is there in terms of terabits. So where people can have large amount of storing of data. So storing capability is very high with digital communication system. That is one major advantage. Secondly, as you see, time is getting progress, digital communication system that is actually inexpensive compared to analog system. So ultimately, digital communication system that is inexpensive, its cost is less, and that even further it will decrease as time pass on. So with respect to time, cost is decreasing. So this is even one major advantage that is there with digital communication system. Third advantage, that is use of repeaters. Now see, what happens is when you send signal for a longer distance, it is possible like signal's property will degrade as it travels to longer distance. But by using repeaters, we can regenerate that signal without having loss of signal. So this is very huge advantage that is there with digital communication system. Like see, for example, if I send signal, this is digital signal, right? And as it pass on, signal property that will degrade with respect to distance. But if you use repeater, you will be having again digital signal like this, right? So without having loss of any data, we can repeat it by using repeater. So that is what one major advantage that is there with digital communication system. Now, next advantage is privacy and security using encryptions. So by using encryption algorithm, we can have privacy and security. So that is not there with analog communication system, but in digital communication system, privacy and security, that is what we can have it by having encryption. Like by rearranging digital data, we can have encryption of data, and that is what providing you privacy. That is what only known to transmitter and receiver. Like see, for example, I have a transmitter over here and I have a receiver over here, right? And if I have digital data like this, so I can rearrange this digital data in other way. So what I will be doing is I'll be rearranging that and then I'll be sending it, and that rearrangement that is only known to transmitter and receiver. So other receiver cannot extract this information. Like see, if I change position, this 2-bit, that is what I'm interchanging. And if I send it, like now new data will be, instead of, see, this is what original data. Now after exchanging this, you'll be finding this data will be 1, this will be 1, 0, 0, 0. So this is what I am sending right now, right? And that is what get received at receiver side. Now this rearrangement, that is what only known to this receiver. So other receiver cannot extract original information. So by using encryption, there are some other encryption methodology even. So by using encryption, privacy and security that can be provided. Next advantage is In digital communication system, data compression, error detection and error correction is possible. So data compression, that could be done if you have large size of data. We can have error detection as well as error correction at receiver side. If you receive data in with added noise, then error detection as well as error correction is possible. So this is very huge advantage that is there with digital communication system, which is not possible in analog communication system. Now see, one another advantage, that is flexible hardware implementation. Like see, the hardware which we use in digital communication system, that will be flexible. The reason is, if system is getting changed, then by changing programs, we can use that for other application. So it is not like analog communication system where if system is getting modified, in that case, in analog communication system, we cannot have that flexibility, like same hardware can be used for other application. While in case of digital communication system, this flexibility is available. By changing programs, we can use it for other applications, like by using VLSI technology, by using microprocessor, we can have flexibility by changing program. So hardware of digital communication system is flexible in terms of use, in terms of applications. So this is even very important advantage that is there with digital communication system. Now, when you work out with multiple signals in digital communication system, so at that time, it is easier and efficient multiplexing that could be done by using time division multiplexing and code division multiplexing. So by using TDMA and CDMA, we can have efficient and easier multiplexing. And this is not possible in analog communication system. So these are various advantages which is making digital communication system so effective. And that's why nowadays almost entire world is using digital communication system only. Nobody is using analog communication system because of these advantages. Now let us discuss few disadvantages even. So you will have to pay some cost. And those costs are bandwidth. So bandwidth per channel, that is very high in digital communication system. If you see nowadays, people are using large bandwidth for data communication. Like at my home, I'm using 50 Mbps connection. So channel bandwidth is very high. So ultimately, this is one drawback for particular channel. But when you talk about multiplexing, so that is this multiplexing that is resolving this issue of bandwidth. But per channel bandwidth is very high. Now see, in digital communication system, it is compulsory to have synchronization. So synchronization circuits, that is highly required when you have digital communication system. If you don't synchronize your data, in that case you will be finding so many errors in received data. So it is compulsory to have synchronization in digital communication system. Next is high power consumption due to multiple stages. See, when you use digital communication system, there are multiple stages that you will be using it in circuit. Like there could be digital to analog. The reason is information can be analog. So all you will be doing is first you will be converting analog signal into digital signal. Once you convert that into digital signal, there are multiple blocks. As I have explained in block diagram, there could be source encoding, there could be channel encoding, there could be digital modulation. So there could be analog to digital converter, there could be digital to analog converter. So all those blocks that will be making system bulky and that will be utilizing more power. So high power consumption that is happening in digital communication system due to multiple stages. So this is even one disadvantage. And one more disadvantage that one can find, which is what complex circuit. So designing of digital communication system, that is very complex. The reason is it requires multiple blocks designing. So circuit will be very bulky in terms of designing, not in terms of size. It will be bulky in terms of designing. Size of digital communication system will be very small. Like you can see in your pocket you are using very compact mobile phone, right? So its size is very less, but designing of that circuit is very complex. So these are the drawbacks which is there with digital communication system. So I have compared an advantages and disadvantages of digital communication system. One can note it down, and this is what giving some motivation to go for working with digital communication system. I find this digital communication system is so interesting. That's why I have worked a lot with digital communication system. And probably if somebody is working with this, there are so many agendas for which they can work out. So these are the comparison of advantages and disadvantages with respect to analog communication system. I hope that you have understood this session. Thank you so much for watching this video. You can give your valuable feedback. Definitely based on that, in future I'll make videos. Thank you so much for watching this video.